In Microsoft Word, we have seen most of the tabs with the major functionalities. Now we'll talk about this file. What does this file tab does? We have discussed most of the aspects, but we'll try to recall them because this is very important. This file, first of all, this is an information. So I opened a file. I don't know what that file is because I just opened Word. But it is giving me all the information. Let me open some other file. This is how we open a file. This is open. Now, those files which I want to open, I can open it from OneDrive, this PC. You can add a place. You can browse also to certain location. But say I have some or the other file. Like this file is there, right? Now, this file, I want to see what information does it provide. So, the size is 3.49 MB. The pages are only one, words are 72. And when did I created it? When did I modify it? Author name, if it is not there, you can add it. So all these things you can see, and also you can change here. This is very important because this makes your file your own, and also some, you know, you can have some your own name, copyright thing here. So this is how you can show the, or you can view the information. Now you can also protect the document. This document you can protect. You can inspect the document. You can also manage the document. That is, if this document sometimes your power failure has happened, so you can just recover that document. If it is unsaved, you can recover the unsaved changes. So these are all the possibilities which you can do. You can protect the document, means you can apply the protection parameters that you don't want it to be modified by others, or you just want to let them modify this part, that part, this you can do. And you can also check for certain issues, that is, you know, right now beyond the discussion scenario, but still the most important aspect is it is giving you all the information. You can change it. So this is the info right now. I opened it already. I showed you. I opened the file. I can go to browse. I can find some file. Say I want to open this file, so I can open that file. Because both the files are same, I just opened it. Now, when I open a new file, this open is finished. Now, let us see new. When I open this file, there is a blank document which is coming to me. It may be different in your Word, say, revision or version. Now, what important thing you can view here is, these are business, education, cards, even letters. So, even letters, flyers, holiday, if you want to type a letter, there are so many letters which are already there. Means you don't have to go to Google, find, download, and then open in doc or in Word. It's already there. See, there is already a document which is presented to you. You just have to change. The content remains same. Means the look, feel, and the formatting remains the same. You just have to change this content, right? So this is very important. When you open a new file, when you open a new file, you always have options. And when I open it, this has come because the Word has known that I am using this kind of formatting or this kind of letters. I can go to, I am having some event. Now I want to plan an event and make certain ticket out of it. So I can just press it. See, this ticket has come. I can just change the name and print and cut and just deliver it. So this is so beautiful, and this is a very powerful, you can say, functionality or the offering of MS Word. So this is how you can open new file. You have various options. You can open file, or even you can go for blank document because you don't want to make it. You don't want anything to be there. You can always open a blank document. So this is how we info, new, and open. Now save. I made a file, right? Say this one. This is the third file. Let me close it. This one. Now I want to save it. I will save it. I can save it to OneDrive. I have, say, ajazpk@outlook.com. I have email ID. I have this. I can save it to PC. I can add a place also. I can browse. So I can save it with certain name. Say I am saving it with tickets. Right? Tickets. Tickets 1, let's say, tickets 1. Okay. Now I saved it. Now I want the same file to be saved, but with different name. How to do this? I can go and say save as. I can say save as, I can browse, and now I can put ticket 2. So these are two separate files with exactly same content. I made it to save as. This is the function of save and save as. Now next is print. I want to print it. When I want to print it, I need to give the copies, the printer, because I don't have any printer attached. So I can print it for as a PDF also. Now these are all one-sided, double-sided, print all pages, some pages, this page only. Then the letter size, you can change the size also at this time. See, the size has changed. You can also customize the margin. You can say, okay, I don't want this margin. I want to increase the margin, decrease the margin, whatever you want to do. You can do it and the page will be set up accordingly. Because these are the tickets, you want more ticket. I say, okay, two pages per sheet. So when it will be printed, there will be 2 pages per sheet. So these are the printing option. You just have to press print so that it will be printed. The next is your share. Now share is when you want to share this content or the document with some people. You want to email it, you want to present in the online or post it to your blog. For all these, you need some configuration that is out of the scope of this discussion, but I'll just show you how to email it. I want to send it as an attachment. So this configuration I have to do with Outlook 2016 or you know whichever Outlook you have. So you have to configure it. I didn't configure it, so that is why it is not happening. Now I want to share it, say post to a blog. See, when I want to post to a blog, there is a new window which is open. I didn't open a blog, so I will register it later, but this will be presented in a blog and you can write content and you can publish it. So those who are interested in blogging or those who are making blogs, they can employ the functionality and the workability of this Word, MS Word, right? Now the next thing is this export. Now export is basically we want to export it in PDF or XPS most of the time. But you can also change the type file type because these are different types. You want to change means you want this to be exported as RTF or rich text format. So you can do like this. It will be saved. You can save it like this. This is the rich text format. So there are various options which are available. You can just choose any of them and you can save it like this. So these are the possibilities you can export. So there are various options in which or various file formats in which you can export it. And close means this file will be closed, not the word, but the file will be closed. So I don't want to save it, so I just closed it. Next is the account. When you are in account, see this is my account. I have no background. I can give some background. See, these backgrounds are changing. And then I can say this, see my information. This is my office, legal office, which I purchased. That is 2016 suite. And I have product key. So this all information will come here. You can also change your photo, you can sign out, switch document, because right now I am in as my name. So I can just go to different account and then work on it, because my drive will be connected to that account, right? That is why this account is important. Next is options. Now we have discussed options when we're discussing the different tabs, but let me just go through it. This is general. General means you want to show mini toolbar on selection or not. You want to enable live preview. This is how you want to change the username, initials. You want some background or not. All these options are there. You can just go through it and you know most of the things will come from here. When you want to display, see, you don't want to show white spaces between pages in print layout view. So you can just say like this, right? But I would recommend you that what all default options are there, let it be like this. Then proofing. Once you are done with your work, now you want to proof it. You want to ignore words in uppercase, you can just unclick it. You say you want checking of spelling as you type, you can just check it, otherwise you can uncheck it. So check grammar with spelling, these are the options which are with you. Then these are the saving options, because auto recovery, because you're not saving, but your document will be saved after 10 minutes. So this is your set auto recover information every 10 minutes. So you can't make it very small, otherwise your document, if it is Raj, will be again saved and saved. So it will hamper your work. The 10 minutes is, I think it's good. And other options are there. Then we have language, you can add any language, you can add any additional language, say Arabic, you can add it and you can work on it. Because I don't want it, I can remove it. This is how we can do. Now these are the more advanced option. Like if you have a link, hyperlink, you can use control click. You can just press control and then click on it so that you can go to that hyperlink. This is tick. So these are some advanced option. You can just see them, the various option, right? Plenty of them. So everything can be done through this word options. You want certain functionality, you don't want certain functionality, this can be done. Now this is customized ribbon. Because you already have this ribbon, you can customize it, you can add or remove. I don't want this blog post, I don't want this. So what do I do? I can just remove it, right? I can remove it, I can tab it up, tab it down, but I want this email to come on my this, so I can just add it like this. But I have to make a group, so I need to make a group, and in this group this will go. So how to make a group? You can make add new group, right? Now you add this to this email, I will come to this group. This is how you can, and this will be added to your ribbon, right? I will remove it because I don't want it. So this is how you can customize your ribbon, means you can add and delete or remove the content. Because see, if you are not using this one, ascending descending, you can remove it. You can add some other thing. Quick access toolbar, right now we have this, see, undo, redo, save, spelling and grammar, cuts and bullets. Say I don't want bullet, I can just remove it, right? I can easily remove it, or I can add some other stuff here. Say I'm doing or performing certain activity again and again, so I would require it. Say just make it a center. So when I add a center, okay, it will come here. And we need to restart this. See, this center has already come and this has centered also. So these are the options which are available to us. We have add-ins also, different add-ins you can add. And these are the trust center. That means this will help keep your document safe and your computer secure and healthy. So these are all the options. We have all seen all the tabs and major functionalities. I hope you are good to go with Microsoft Word. Thank you so much and take care of yourself.